grind those down and see what I'm dealing with, if I got big holes or whatever, and I just don't wanna use, you know, I just, it takes too long to dry, cause it's cold.
Okay.
And the same way. See, this side's not that bad. Them big holes that are on that side are where most of the moisture went in. This side only has one hole in there, so it's not rusted as bad.
Yeah, take a look underneath though.
I know, but, well, underneath, when the car's made, when these cars were made, yeah, I see that. But when these cars were made, they didn't get dipped like they do nowadays. They just got primed from the outside. And whatever primer got wherever it got, they didn't, underneath there is just kind of bare metal. It's not like the new cars that have, the whole car goes through a dip, and all the metal gets sealed. Now, you know, it's better, but these older cars didn't have that. We just gotta do it like it is. You know, the guy don't want it fixed for 100 years, he just needs to fix it. The leaks that were coming through his roof on his CB. It didn't peel away already. Look. You don't want this guy's fucking. So it's. You see? I'm gonna make it fly, though. See, look, I just chipped it right there.
Yeah.
And there's no showing of rust. There, look, there's rust. Right there, look, there's rust. There's rust behind what you see.
Right.
And it's from those holes in the front where the moisture built up underneath here. Moisture rises. And when moisture rises, it can't get out of this roof. So it, the more it keeps rising, it never gets out. And it coagulates, or whatever you want to call it, the humidity intensifies and gets right here underneath this lip, and it rusts all these.